Hey everybody, it's Adam and Brooke from ImaginaryLemons.com. Welcome back to our channel.
So if you've seen our previous videos, you know that we planned this Disney trip to get content for our blog and show you what it's like to visit Disney as a wheelchair user. However,
things didn't go as planned like we wanted to do. We got COVID.
Yeah, we did. You know, we avoided it for 2 years. We did. Coughing break. We may or may not put that in. Okay. We avoided it for, you know, two plus years. We were vaccinated and boosted and followed all the guidelines, and we still got it. You know, it's but we are grateful that we have mild cases. We're both high risk, and so we've been very careful, and we, you know, it happens. And so here we are at Disney, in Coronado Springs Hotel, with COVID. This is our sixth trip this year. So, we certainly don't blame Disney for getting COVID. We never had it before. You know, you can get it at a grocery store. You can get it, you know, just living life. So, this video isn't meant to suggest that Disney is unsafe or anything of that sort. But we wanted to give you a firsthand account of what it's like to get COVID in the middle of a Disney trip.
Before we jump into the special procedures for managing COVID at Disney, we want to talk a little bit about what we do when you get sick at Disney.
Getting medical attention at Disney, there are a number of options available to you. My first recommendation would be to, before you even come here, look at your own health insurance and see what virtual medical services may be available to you. Our particular health insurance and many others participate in a app-based service called Close-Knit Health, and we could text the system and say, hey, I'm not feeling well. And they were able to get me a same day virtual appointment. I think I had an appointment within an hour. And they did an initial screen. I didn't think I had COVID at first. And so I was having asthma issues. And so we were able to talk to an advisor and get that out of the way. And it's no cost to us. Fortunately, Close-Knit is a national chain, which worked out well for us because, generally speaking, the medical provider needs to be licensed in the place where you're currently standing. So since we were in Florida, we needed a Florida-based or Florida-licensed healthcare provider. So this is in no way sponsored by Close-Knit. We have no relationship with Close-Knit. However, it was very helpful to us in this time, so we thought we would share that.
Disney has a partnership with Advent Health. You can use their services. They have both a 24/7 urgent care center and also a virtual system that you also can use. Using the virtual system, you would have to sign up for it and all that stuff, of course. But of course, it has a cost to it. So we will also link that below how much it costs. They also have a discount code for guests that use that service.
If you are experiencing an emergency, use the room phone and call 911. That will go directly to the Reedy Creek Emergency Services, and they will send an ambulance and EMS to your hotel. I have actually needed to use that service on a previous visit, and I can tell you that they were completely professional and very helpful. Those are your options in terms of getting in front of a medical practitioner to get assistance.
So now we're going to talk about if you need to get medication. There are several national chains like Walgreens and CVS that have delivery services that you can use. Advent Health Services also provide pharmacy services and will be able to deliver to your hotel.
If you needed something over the counter or even an at-home COVID test, you could use a grocery delivery service like Instacart to get those from a number of grocery stores.
In our case, we ordered a COVID test and they came back positive. And so now we test a positive at Disney. What do we do?
When you have COVID, CDC recommends that you go into an isolation period. Disney will provide you with a couple of options for doing that. A lot of people will choose to end their trip early and just go home, and that's fine. However, if you want to stay on property and do your isolation in the Disney hotel, Disney will be very supportive of that. They're going to ask you to avoid leaving your room. If there are people in your traveling party who are not positive for COVID, they will ask that those people wear a mask at any time that they're leaving the room. But if you are positive, they want you to stay in place. Instead of you leaving the room, they will bring anything you need to the room.
Right.
They contacted us and gave us a cell phone number to contact the resort manager. And there's someone always on call. And if we need anything, we text that number and then they help us out. So whether that was extra coffee supplies or wanting.
Towels and stuff like that, mobile orders we had to put through because not every restaurant had mobile order here in Colorado Springs, but the manager was able to help us get that mobile order put through so we could stay in our room and not go out and potentially infect other people.
Exactly. They will also bring anything that you have delivered to the hotel to your room. So, under normal circumstances, if you have an Instacart grocery delivery or something, or an Uber Eats order, and you want Bell Services to bring it to your room, there's a $6 charge for each delivery. They will waive that if you're in the Disney quarantine, and they will just bring those things to your room.
Another thing Disney will implement is a no mousekeeping services. Their mousekeeping services is their housekeeping staff and things like that. So you won't have any mousekeeping services. You will not have, unfortunately, no bell services, which means luggage assistance and things like that.
Basically, Disney wants to avoid any excess interactions between you and the staff. And in fact, when they do bring things to your door, they will come to the door, knock on the door, wait for you to acknowledge, and then they'll put the package down and walk away, and then you open the door. And that way, you're not interacting with the staff member, you're not putting them at risk. So they obviously want to protect their staff from, transmitting disease. And then here's the biggie. Disney does not want you going to the park if you have COVID.
When you inform Disney of your results, they will put a hold on your park passes.
Obviously, they don't want you putting other guests at risk, and that is completely understandable. And
Yeah,
I
I
certainly
understand.
wish whoever infected us had not gone into the park that day. So it's an understandable policy. Disney will put a hold on your ticket media for 5 days from the point at which they're notified following the CDC guidelines. If you have an annual pass like we do, that doesn't make that much of a difference because then your annual pass is just reactivated 5 days later and you're fine. If you haven't yet used your multi-day ticket, then those can usually be rescheduled to another time, and Disney can help you do that. Or, of course, your travel agent can help you with that as well. And if you've partially used your ticket, this is where it gets a little tricky. If you have days remaining on your ticket, Disney, we talked to a cast member, actually, we talked to two cast members, and they confirmed that they deal with those on a case-by-case basis. So, generally speaking, once you enter the park on a multi-day ticket, your ticket is now limited to that window that you received when you purchased the ticket. So, depending on the number of days you had available on the ticket. Once you activate it, it is now considered non-refundable and non-transferable. However, talk to Disney. They may be able to help you. Another option, if you purchase travel insurance, which is why we always recommend purchasing travel insurance, is that you might be able to file a claim with your travel insurance. In order to do that, you will most likely need a letter from a doctor stating that you had COVID-19. A photo of your at-home test kit is not going to do it. So definitely talk to the doctor, get that verification if you think you're going to need to go that route. Another option that was made available to us when we had our conversation with Disney was that if we wanted to extend our stay in order to do our entire isolation period here at Disney, we could do that at a discounted rate for those additional nights. And so we did take advantage of that because we wanted to make sure that we were outside of that isolation period before we got on planes and taxis and all
Right,
of
just some
that. So
background. If you decide to stay, Disney does provide something called a wellness rate, which they will allow you to stay there in quarantine for an extended amount of time past your checkout date.
that is our experience having COVID at Disney. Certainly isn't the trip that we were looking for, but it has certainly been informative, to say the
Yes, it
least.
has. It was. Yeah, I think it's a experience that you should not want to ever happen. But now that you have gone through it with us, you're a little bit better informed about what you can do and what your options are.
And there are worse places to be stuck. Like,
Yeah.
let's just be clear here. I feel privileged that we were vaccinated and boosted, so we had a much more mild case than many people. Yes, we're doing a lot of coughing. We've had to stop this video a couple of times for coughing fits. Apologies for any that we missed getting out of there for you. But it certainly hasn't been easy. It's no fun being sick,
No.
but it's a comfortable bed. It is an accessible room. The room is gorgeous. I mean, it's a little bit of a mess now because we've had no mousekeeping, but
Yeah.
it's still a fantastic room. They're bringing us everything. We're not having to prepare meals. I mean, there's worse places to be. So yes, this was not the situation we wanted, but it certainly is much better than it could have been. And
Yeah.
so I'm thankful to Disney for the assistance that they provided. And I like certainly wouldn't wish this on anybody, but now
No.
you know what happens. It certainly isn't the end of the world if you end up getting COVID at Disney. If I had to be stuck somewhere, Disney World is a great place to be stuck, even if I can't go to the park.
We thank you for watching. We would hope that you would like and subscribe to this video.
And remember, anyone can make lemonade out of lemons, but to use imaginary lemons takes determination, creativity, and style. Stay well, everyone.
Thank you.